I told you.
I have never, ever seen this before. You know what, though? Someone spent a lot of time to make this happen. Yeah, seriously, right. Someone was here for, like, weeks.
Yep.
This is pretty much the living room, and then dining room here with the kitchen over here to the corner.
What were you guys thinking about this wall?
We're thinking of opening it up.
Yeah, opening up.
This is really small.
Yes.
It's a full gut, pretty much.
So, yeah, I mean, this floor is beat up, the subfloor shot, the ceiling shot. You know what I like about you, too? Like, you guys are rookie flippers, and you guys buy the worst of the worst. Like, you find the worst possible rookie houses you could possibly buy. I would open up that living room wall, and when you demo this kitchen wall, you can add a peninsula. The entire space will feel bigger. So come here.
Bathroom, not bad, not a bad size, but once again, full gut.
Yes.
You know what? This isn't a bad bathroom at all, actually. Once you come in here, new floor, retile the whole thing, I don't see any, like, major problems.
First bedroom right here off to the right.
The size itself isn't bad, but the flooring feels really uneven. Right now, walking through the entire house, your foundation feels like it's shot in so many different areas. So if you're gonna stay at 80K, you better hope this isn't a big job. Oh, and they just love these very interesting ceilings.
Yeah.
What is that?
That's a shed.
That's gotta go.
Yeah, that's going.
This is bedroom 3 and 4.
Three, somewhere in here, but we're gonna make it officially a 3 and 4.
This, like, 100% looks like an unpermitted addition. So please tell me you verify the permit.
We checked, and it's permitted.
It is permitted?
It is permitted. It looks funky. Even we were second-guessing it, but it's permitted. It's in the plans.
I haven't seen that, so I'm going off of what he says, but he says it's permitted.
I know, but I've confirmed it.
All right, because everything I'm seeing right now says not permitted. I mean, look at that. So what is the plan in here?
So the plan is to literally divide it, kind of what they have, but legitly. We're gonna close the door to the living room. Then we're gonna borrow space from the second bedroom to create a new hallway down the middle. Door here for this room, door here for that room. And that, there's another restroom back there, and that'll be a master.
I'm actually impressed.
Oh, okay.
Hey.
There you go.
I'm actually impressed. That is actually a really good idea, guys.
So this right here is gonna become the master bedroom. Don't look up, though. Don't look up.
Don't get scared.
Oh, my God. You have, like, major roof problems, major roof problems. You might have plumbing problems. You might have electric problems. So I think there's a lot of stuff here that is going to come up that's hidden behind all these walls. Oof. This is a huge yard, guys. Where's your garage?
We don't have one.
You guys don't have a garage?
No. We don't have a garage.
Do the comps have garages?
They do have garages.
Buyers are going to see a missing garage as a huge negative. So we need to make sure they see a positive instead, which is a big backyard. But the biggest priority is getting a handle on the real cost. There's so much going on here, so many red flags.
Kind of scared about this.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
We're here at the property. Everything's looking good. But we did get a little bit of bad news.
What do you mean bad news?
The contractor just told us that, you know, the part where we're adding the third bedroom and the fourth bedroom and the master bath, it might have to come down.
Are you saying it's not permitted?
Yeah.
When we first walked that property, do you remember I stepped down into those bedrooms and I was like, this doesn't feel permitted?
Yeah, I do.
You said what?
And I said, Tarek, it is permitted.
Well, why did you say that?
I got the information from my agent. I looked online. Everything seemed to pan out.
Okay, I'm gonna teach you something right now. Looking online means nothing. Talking to agents means nothing. You want that in writing. You need that in writing.
Yeah.
If you have to take that addition down, this house is a loser. You don't have the square footage, you have extra costs, you're gonna lose a fortune. The number one thing you should have done is gone to the city and verified those permits.
That's the thing I didn't do.
Victor's overconfidence led him into a huge disaster. The real estate agent, they just told him what he wanted to hear. He never verified it with the city, and if they can't figure out a way to keep the addition, they're gonna lose their shirts on this flip.
Remember this conversation, because if this, you can't do this again.
Yeah, I know. It turns out back in the 70s, the owners pulled permits for the back addition, but they never finished it. So right now, we don't have no idea as to when it's gonna get inspected and approved. But now we have to stop work, and holding costs keep rising.
While Victor and Deanna wait on permits,
I want them to focus on really high design finishes so they can compete with the new construction down the street.
So what do we have here?
So this will go in the both the floors in the bathroom, and then we'll put it on the back side of the peninsula.
Okay.
This will go in the showers.
Okay.
And on the backsplash of the kitchen. And then, of course, those are going to be the cabinets with some black hardware.
Perfect. You guys are designing today.
Yeah.
I like it. You ready to go with it? I need a signature and I need a credit card.
What is that? Hey, this is my personal filing, system here.
Are these receipts for, like, house flipping things?
No.
It's everything.
No.
I have it kind of fair.
We don't know where those are.
So if you're not keeping receipts as deduction and improvements to the property, you're going to pay taxes on that money. You're giving away thousands of dollars.
It looks more, it's more organized than it looks, okay?
No, it's not.
But
at all.
Let's get this going.
Moving forward, anytime you spend a dollar on anything, you're going to keep the receipt, take a picture of it. Create a file with the property address in your email. Every time you take a picture, email it to that.
Okay.
You have to track expenses.
Yeah.
All right, sign your life away.
All right.
All right, you guys.
We are up and running again. We got the permits approved, and now we're moving forward.
Your mistake actually pushed us back 2 months, and we ended up spending $7,000 extra. I'm worried that we're not actually going to be making any profit at this point.
Design-wise, nailed it.
Yeah.
It looks awesome. Functionality-wise, I don't see any cabinets. And really, you should have upper and lower cabinets across this entire wall. Where do you store your stuff? That's not storage, right? That's underneath the sink.
Cleaning supply, yeah.
Where do you store your stuff?
Deanna was on me to save money, but hopefully now that the wall's open, we have some nice, beautiful countertops, that distracts them from that.
Victor, are you insane? You don't think a buyer's gonna notice that there are no cabinets here and there are brand new homes for sale right up the street? If your budget is maxed, at least have your sager put in a hutch over here because this is a huge problem.
Hi.
Hi. Hi.
Come on in.
And see, there's a lot of light from the window. Mm-hmm.
It's amazing how far this house made it, man.
Mm-hmm. I mean, just looking at the ceiling and not seeing that ugly popcorn sticking out.
It's very modern.
Very.
Look at the sink.
There are no cabinets at all. I have a whole set of pants and all kinds of stuff.
See, I told you, man, you can't fool the buyers.
Okay.
Look at the tile
on
the bathroom.
I love the bathroom.
It matches the peninsula.
This tile is really not my favorite.
And then here's the bedroom. Nice size. It's really cool how we created a real functional floor plan out of a very unfunctional house.
Big time. Yeah. We added a fourth bedroom. I mean, we really reconfigured it to so that it really flows very well.
I don't know, the bedroom looks a little small.
I was pretty worried about that, but honestly, that's just the trade-off when you take existing square footage and try to make more rooms.
Oh,
look at this.
This is my master bedroom.
She said, this is mine. Did you hear that?
Beautiful bathroom.
Beautiful.
I love this shower because this.
Yeah, look at the nice glass. The master bath has that, like, super high-end feel, and it's way better than the new construction. I just hope it's enough to convince buyers to make an offer.
But I like the other bathroom better.
This is huge.
See? The first thing the kid said, this is huge yard.
Hey, we can put your prayer structure.
And I can help your garden.
Next to the permits, leaving that yard as dirt would have been the biggest mistake in this entire flip. Even though the house looks great, like, I still don't know if we're gonna be able to pull buyers away from those new construction homes right up the street. We're just gonna have to wait and see. And one last thing before we go here, I wanna see the wallet.
Uh-oh.
The one in your pocket, Victor. Your wallet. That's the last thing I wanna see. Oh, did he get a new wallet? Before it was like this big.
Oh yeah, well.
So.
I'm doing better.
It's not the best.
But it's better.
Despite this flip almost going belly up, it looks like the market is gonna bail Victor and Deanna out. 1 week after they listed the house, they accepted an offer at $545,000, $10,000 above asking. That's a profit of $69,000. But when it comes to this flip, it was never a sure thing.